Welcome to my channel, detailing events throughout the decades. 1991. 10. Downing Street Attack. During the Troubles, as part of its armed campaign against British rule in Northern Ireland, the Provisional IRA repeatedly used homemade mortars against their targets in Northern Ireland. The IRA carried out many attacks in England, but had not used mortars there yet. In December 1988, items used in the construction and technical details regarding the weapon's trajectory were found during a raid in Battersea, South London. In the late 1980s, British Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher was top of the IRA's list for assassination, following the failed attempt on her life in the Brighton Hotel bombing. Security around Downing Street had been stepped up, following the increased IRA activity in England in 1988. This security included police guard posts and security gates at the end of the street. Plans to leave a car bomb on the street near Downing Street, and detonate it by remote control as Margaret Thatcher's car was driving past, had been ruled out by the IRA's Army Council, due to the likelihood of civilian casualties. The IRA Army Council instead sanctioned a mortar attack on Downing Street, and in the mid-1990s two IRA members travelled to London to plan the attack. A Ford Transit van was brought, and a garage was rented. An IRA member procured the explosives and materials needed to make the mortars. The IRA members began making the mortars, as well as cutting a hole in the roof of the van for the mortars to be launched through. They went to find a suitable place in Whitehall from which the mortars could be launched at the back of Downing Street. Once these preparations were completed, the two IRA members returned back to Northern Ireland. However, in November 1990, Margaret Thatcher unexpectedly resigned from office, but it was decided that the planned attack should still go ahead, targeting her successor, John Major. The planned attack was for when John Major and his ministers were likely to be meeting at Downing Street. They patiently waited for the cabinet meeting to be publicly known. On the morning of February 7, 1991, the War Cabinet and senior government were meeting at Downing Street to discuss the ongoing Gulf War. As the meeting began, an IRA member was driving the van to the launch site ready for the attack. The attack site was at the junction of Horse Guards Avenue and Whitehall, near the Ministry of Defence headquarters, around 200 yards from Downing Street. On arrival, the driver parked the van and left the scene on a waiting motorbike. At 10 a.m., as a policeman was walking towards the van to investigate it, three mortar shells were launched, followed by the explosion of a preset incendiary device. This device was designed to destroy any forensic evidence and set the van on fire. Each shell was 4.5 feet long, and weighed 140 pounds. They carried a 40-pound payload of plastic explosive Semtex. Two shells landed on Mount Batten Green, while one exploded, the other failed to detonate. The third shell exploded in the back garden of 10 Downing Street, 30 yards from the office where the cabinet was meeting. It is said that if the shell had struck Downing Street, it is very likely that the entire cabinet would have been killed. On hearing the explosion, the cabinet ducked for cover. Bomb-proof netting on the windows of the cabinet office muffled the force of the explosion, which scorched the back wall of the building, smashed windows, and made a crater several feet deep in the garden. The room was evacuated and the meeting reconvened less than 10 minutes later in the Cobra Room. No members of the cabinet were hurt, but four people received minor injuries, including two police officers. After the attack, hundreds of police sealed off the government district all the way from the Houses of Parliament to Trafalgar Square until 6 p.m. Civilians were kept out of that area so forensic experts could comb the area. The government employees were kept locked behind the security gates. The IRA claimed responsibility for the attack with a statement issued in Dublin, saying, "Let the British government understand that, while nationalist people in the six counties are forced to live under British rule, then the British cabinet will be forced to meet in bunkers." John Major told the House of Commons that our determination to beat terrorism cannot be beaten by terrorism. The IRA's record is one of failure in every respect, and that failure was demonstrated yet again today. It's about time they learned that democracies cannot be intimidated by terrorism, and we treat them with contempt. Luckily no one was killed in the attack, but it made people more vigilant against future attacks. Thank you for watching and learning about events throughout history. Please subscribe to my channel to view other events throughout the decades.